Wood and welcome back to Liquid Martial Arts YouTube channel. In this episode 17, we're going to go over a little bit more deeper under body control. And what I mean by that is if someone's ever going to approach me and invade my space, I need to know what their body language is saying, and I need a little bit of a barrier that keeps distance between me and them. So for example, here's some key points. One is wrist control. I just monitor the wrist. I can physically grab the wrist, but they're most likely going to react. But I'm just checking the wrist by having my hands near it while I'm talking. This could be the same for the bicep, the shoulder, the elbow, and also the head and the shoulders. And what I also mean by this, say, let's say Joanne is going to approach me and the body language is not looking right, and my hand's down here, I'm in a very bad position. So for example, if she came up close and we're just talking and she gave me a headbutt all of a sudden, I'm not ready. And this has happened to me before. So what I would do is keep the hands up, like we said in the previous episodes, and when she does just walk towards me, I can sit there and just monitor. Remember, we're going to try and talk with our hands at the same time as we're verbally in escalation or trying to understand what's going on. So for example, if she walks towards me, I could be just here on the bicep, invading my space. Now, if she decides to hit me with that arm, I can monitor that arm. I can feel things, what's going on, right? Same thing for the shoulders. She walks towards me, I've got the shoulders pinned here. She tries to headbutt me now, it's not going to happen. But if I hold the bicep and she headbutts me, it can happen. So the thing is, you've got to play with what's going on. So even if her hands are up and she comes towards me, I'm just holding my hands here, I'm just checking it. I can physically grab, but now I'm attacking. So what I'm doing is I'm just monitoring it. So if she decides to walk towards me and so forth, I can move from a different position by just manipulating her limbs. So at the end of the day, I call this body control and sensitivity, because at the end of the day, if I've got any kind of placement on someone's body, I can feel what they're going to do. Are they going to withdraw to hit me? Are they going to come forward? I will feel this through my own arms, okay? So the things we're looking for is wrist, because if I control the wrist, now I can manipulate this arm. But Joanna can reverse this, which is a nice little flow drill that we do in training, and she's going to now grab my wrist by turning it over here and grabbing my wrist, and I'll do the same back. I'm in a positive position, and she does the same, and she's in the best position. Same thing comes to the elbow. If I've got the control of the back of the elbow, I can drag, I can lift up, and so forth. But if Joanna just grabs my elbow, now she's in a better position. This is where I've got to regain control. This is all the same for the bicep. If I control the bicep, it's very hard for her to hit me, because now I can feel what's going on. But what she can do is push on my bicep, now she has the control. Now I'm in control. So at the end of the day, it becomes a bit of a game. Now, also the same thing is with the shoulder. If I hold the shoulders, you know what I mean, she can't hit me. Not even me hold the shoulders, but just be near the shoulders so I can kind of feel what, anything that's going to happen. I can know if I want to disengage, if I want to act first, or control the situation, okay? And it's obviously taken to another level, especially if you're a bouncer or if you're someone who's trying to like stop someone intruding into your house. Obviously there's different levels of threat, which we go through in the early episodes to know what you should do, but at the end of the day is you want to have yourself at peace and at a good distance. But sometimes you don't have that distance, so sometimes you've got to play with your own body against their body. Another thing as well is if I control the head here, once I control the head in early episodes, if I control it here or the head, I basically control the body. But if Joanna goes inside and grabs my head, now she's got the control because my arm's got no power now. I haven't got as much control as she does me because she's in the inside. So I have to then get into a better position. So this obviously goes the same on the other side. So I call this body control because I want to manipulate and control the body by just checking. Once again, it could be physical by actually grabbing, or I could just hold it here. So if she does approach me, I'm stopping her movement or anything that she could do because I've got kind of a bit of a barrier going on. So that's body control. So let's go through a couple of examples. Rebecca. Hey Rebecca, I want to speak to you.
Oh, sorry, can you just move back?
No, I just want to speak to Rebecca.
No, she was not going to talk to you right now, okay?
I want to speak to Rebecca.
Can you move back,
please? I want to speak to Rebecca.
She's not going to talk to you right now, okay? She won't talk to you.
Well, just tell her that I'm going to be outside waiting for her. That's cool. Hey, I just want to speak to her just quickly. Come on, I really need to speak to her.
Rebecca, hey, Rebecca. Step back, step
okay,
back.
Please, please, please.
Seriously,
please,
can you just
please.
Move away?
Yeah,
no, go.
did is we showed you just a couple of scenarios. Obviously, there's many more scenarios. Every situation is different. But the most important thing about this video is having the advantage of your placement of your hands. So you can be a step ahead of the game if anything does go a little bit wrong. Also, you've noticed that Joanna got me into a rear naked choke. Okay, we haven't really demonstrated how to apply that and what defenses we can do there, but they'll come up in the future video. So stay tuned and click the notification button, and I'll see you in the next one. Loose.